Do you want to learn how to paint like Wayne Thiebaud, also known as the pie and cake painting artist? I will show you in this artwork for beginner tutorial, just after this. Hey, Albert here at Imperfect Paintings, where it's all about improving your painting skills by looking at art, yourself and the world around you. If you're new to this channel, consider subscribing and hit the bell so you don't miss a single video. I will show you how I painted this one, and later on you will see the artwork made by the participants of my painting course, so stay tuned. This summer I went to the exhibition of Wayne Thiebaud paintings in Museum Voorlinden in the Netherlands and fell in love with his artwork. Looking at them, I just wanted to lick these ice cream cones and definitely craved for some cake and pie later that day. Fun gesture of the museum was the pop-up bakery located in the garden next to the museum, where you could have your sugar rush with your favorite Wayne Thiebaud cake or pie. Yummy! When I look at these paintings by Wayne Thiebaud, I see a colder palette of colors. It reminds me of things in the 1950s in a way, somewhat pastel colors. A dark shadow, strange colors that you don't expect, but they do work. Painting around, following the form of the cake, little bits of color along all lines. Notice that he painted with oil paint, and then you can make it easily look pasty, like real cream. I really had to buy some extra materials for these paintings, so let's do a little unboxing. In the Netherlands we call these tompoes. In other countries, pastry like this is generally known as millefeuille or Napoleon pastry. All the materials I use are in the description below. The perspective of the tompoes on the plate is a bit different to me than to you, looking from more above. I paint how I see it. I now mark more or less the surroundings of the saucer under the tompoes. Followed by the table where the saucer stands on. Later on, you will see how I change the shape and correct the perspective of the round saucer to the oval shape you have to paint. When editing this video, I started to drool. Luckily, we had a birthday to celebrate, and this is what entered our house. It was gone before we knew it. Let me show you how this shape changes when looking from a different angle. Sometimes it's easier to paint from a different place. Don't hesitate to move yourself or your painting around to be able to paint more precise. This is the moment that I discovered that my digital camera only records for 30 minutes. This happened after painting this and having an empty battery after 15 minutes recording. So I started again and made my second painting you just watched. I needed a break and started for the third time covering the finished painting with titanium white so I can show you how I do it. I made this painting more or less three times over. And noticed that it got better. It got easier. The more you paint, the better you get. I can tell you that. Painting a shadow is difficult these days. We are used to multiple sources of light in our rooms. Look around you and count them. The result is that you never see those intense shadows Wayne Thiebaud paints. You can experience them by turning off all the light and lighting just one candle. As you can see, this is the moment that I missed my tompoes to look at for getting the perspective right, but it tasted great. Thank you. Question of the day. What's your favorite pastry, pie or cake? Let me know in the comments down below. And as promised earlier, here's the artwork made by the participants of my painting course. Enjoy! If you like this video, hit subscribe and click on the bell so you don't have to miss a single video. Share this video with a friend and click or tap on the screen to see another one. And until next time, keep painting!